Good morning, everyone. Welcome to First Baptist Church Children's Sunday School online program. Let us worship our Lord together.
Today, it always goes to those who don't deserve. It's the opposite of how you feel when the pain they caused is just too real. Takes everything you have to say the word forgiveness. Forgiveness. In the face of all your pride, it moves away the mad inside. It's always anger's own worst enemy. Even when the jury and the judge say you got a right to hold a grudge, it's the whisper in your ear saying set it free. Forgiveness. Set a prisoner free. There is no end to what its power can do. So let it go and be amazed by what you see through eyes of grace. The prisoner that it really frees is you. Forgiveness. Forgiveness.
Let us come to the Lord and pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the moment you have given us to gather here and assemble online to learn more about you. Help us, Lord, in understanding. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So guys, today's lesson is taken from Matthew 18, verse 21 to 35. Let us start. What makes a person or a person in a particular situation worthy of forgiveness? Yes, that person got dragged into someone else's poor choices, or the person is genuinely sorry, or the person made mistakes, or the person is suitable for forgiveness all the time because of Jesus. You will watch a video of a woman in Ohio. Samantha Davis was arrested for drug possession and causing a fatal car accident that killed a woman and her daughter. At the court hearing for Samantha Davis, the victim's family member expressed forgiveness for what Samantha had done.
I want Ms. Davis to know I do not hate her. I have forgiven her.
Next, we're in Cincinnati, Ohio, for the sentencing of Samantha Davis. The 28-year-old was found guilty of 2 counts of aggravated drug possession and 2 counts of vehicular homicide after she lost control of her truck and sent it careening off an overpass, crushing an oncoming car below. Inside that vehicle, a 67-year-old woman and her adult daughter were killed instantly. Davis was ejected from her truck but survived with minor injuries. At the time, she was driving on a suspended license, and investigators believe she crushed and snorted prescription pain pills prior to the accident. Now at sentencing, Everett Miller, whose ex-wife and daughter were killed in the accident, shares a victim impact statement.
Losing a child in any case is painful. My children have lost both their mother and their sister, and every day it is difficult. I live with the knowledge that I will not get to hold her or to hug her or to hear her say to me, "Hey, Dad," when she greeted me.
Amid his own grief, Miller then acknowledges Samantha Davis, who can be seen crying just a few feet away.
I want Ms. Davis to know I do not hate her. I have forgiven her. I think justice, however, needs to be served.
What do you think went on in the father's mind and heart in order for him to reach the conclusion to forgive? Maybe he felt the physical pain and was angry but genuinely cares about people? When you are in a situation where someone has wronged you, is it easy or difficult to forgive? If Samantha Davis caused another fatal car crash, do you think she would be worthy of forgiveness? What is your response when someone you have forgiven repeats the same behavior after you forgave him or her at the first time? Mostly you will getting mad, deciding not to forgive this time. Or maybe you will give them 3 strikes, you are out. After being forgiven by the victim's family, how do you expect Davis to treat people who hurt her? Hopefully, she will offer forgiveness. Forgiving others may sound easy, but in practice, it can be difficult. When we are hurt, we may want the person who offended us to pay in some way for the pain we feel. Although it can be challenging, forgiveness is a vital part of a Christian's life. In today's lesson, we will get some insight into the importance of forgiveness.
Have you ever been so angry at someone that it was hard to forgive them? One day, Peter asked Jesus, "How many times shall I forgive someone who sins against me? 7 times? In Jesus' time, the priests and rabbis taught that people only had to forgive a person 3 times. So Peter thought he was being generous by suggesting the number 7. "Not 7 times," Jesus said, "but 70 times 7. Jesus meant that we should not count the times that we forgive someone. We should be willing and ready to forgive. Then Jesus told a story to make his point. A certain man worked for a king, managing the king's money. One day the king sat down to look at his accounts. He discovered This man's account was millions in debt, far more than the man could ever repay. The king ordered the man, his wife, and his children to be sold, and everything he owned was to be sold. All the money would help to repay the debt. The man fell on his knees and begged for mercy. "Give me time," he said, "and I will repay everything I owe." The king knew the man could never repay so much money, but the king felt sorry for the man, so he canceled the debt and let his servant go. The king's servant was so relieved he rushed away. On his way out, he met another servant, one who owed him money. It was just a little bit, about a day's wages. The king's servant grabbed the second man by the neck, and he began choking him.
"Pay me back the money you owe me," he demanded.
"Please be patient with me," begged the second man. "Give me time, and I will repay back everything I owe you." But the king's servant refused. He had the second man thrown in prison until he could repay the debt. Other servants of the king saw the whole thing. They immediately reported it to the king. The king called the first servant back.
"You wicked servant," he stormed. "I canceled millions you owed me. Shouldn't you have had the same mercy on someone else? Someone who owed you so little?"
The king had his servant taken away to prison. We are like the king's servant. He owed more than he could ever repay. We can never be good enough, but just as the king forgave his servant, God has forgiven our sins. And since God has forgiven us, he asks us to treat others with mercy and kindness and forgiveness.
When we know true forgiveness, it is our responsibility to offer forgiveness to others. When Jesus died for us, he paid the price for our sin. His death and resurrection assure us of forgiveness. Starting from now, when we pray, we could ask God to forgive us. And we have to think about how freeing it is to know that God does not hold that sin against us. Think about how God forgave you. How can you not forgive another person after God forgave you? Let us live as one who is forgiven and allow the person you forgive to live that way too. So guys, remember always that we need to forgive others as God forgave us. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for your message today that remind us to always forgive others as you forgive us. Help us, Lord, in applying your word in our daily life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. So guys, thank you for joining our Sunday School online program. See you next week. God bless you. Our Bible memory verse is taken from Mark 11, verse 25. And when you stand praying, if you hold anything against anyone, forgive them, so that your Father in heaven may forgive you your sins. Mark 11, verse 25.